MGU, I hope y'all record this, man, just as well. Just in case mine mess up or y'all's mess up, at least we got somebody who recorded it, you know what I mean? Hold up. I'm trying to give everybody some time to get over here. People on different time zones. Some of them waiting till right at 8 o'clock. If it ain't a lot of people over here, that's because they've been sheltered once again. And been told not to come over here because they want to believe in the unbelievable. Can y'all hear me? Yes or no? What up with it? Can y'all hear me? Yes or no? I'm going to be asking this for the next few minutes, so I want to make sure everybody can hear. What's up, Beverly? What up, Sheila? Glad you guys can hear me. Glad you guys are here. Latonya, what's up? Glad you guys can hear me. What's up, Sabrina? April, what's up? All the ladies in here. Wait a minute. Hold up. What the fellas? Hold up. Ladies, no, nah, I'm not, you know, I ain't gonna never trip with y'all. Y'all already know that. I know my place. I know not to say nothing about no woman over here. But I'm glad you guys can hear me. We're trying to let this room get full. Tell your friends to get over here right now. Go to your private chats, your Skypes, your Facebooks. Share the link. I want the whole world over here. I don't even care if they ain't even inside of this deal. The world needs to know. The world needs to know what's going on over here. So if you got family, friends, and people that want to know what's going on inside of something that don't nobody know what's going on, tell them to get on over here so we can tell them we can get this petition signed for this man to stake his butt in jail for those that's going to stay they butt there too. So let's do it. Hey, share the link. It's up there somewhere. Y'all seen it. I don't know. It's, y'all know. Just scroll back. You know. You see it. Matter of fact, I'll put it in here one more time. Well, hold on. Let me put it in one more time. Let me copy, paste. Bam. Bada boom. Bada bang. There it is right there. Okay. I'm giving people a little time to get over here, so y'all just bear with me for 1 minute. You know, I got this thinking of a master plan. Say nothing but sweat inside my hand. This is called being paid in full because that's what they've done. They've been paid in full from us. Yeah. That's why I played this song tonight, y'all. Y'all thought I was going to leave y'all hanging like that? That's why I'm playing it tonight. They've been paid in full. Okay? I'm just letting y'all know it. All right? But we're going to touch on that in a minute. Make sure y'all share the link. Tell them to get on over here if they ain't even in the deal. I don't care if you send it to Biden, Mnuchin, all them folk that was supposed to be up in this thing that know what's going on. Send them the link. Let them know that it's going on over here and that their name's been mentioned in a deal that ain't real. Tell them to get over here now. Somebody hit Biden up or Pence or something. Not Pence. Well, hit Pence too so we can tell Trump. Tell him. Tell Mnuchin. Tell Bezos. Tell what's the other name? What's the Tesla dude name? I keep forgetting that. You know, Elon. Tell him. Send him an email right now. Send it on Twitter. Tell everybody get over. Put it on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, YouTube. Hell, you can send it to Cash App. Tell them to get over here. I just posted a link. Please send me the link. I can't get in. I just posted it. Let me put it in your private chat. Hold on. Where you at? Let me put it in your private chat. What's up, son? All right. Bam. Ooh, you can't even get messages. I can't. You can't even get messages. I just tried to send it to you. Somebody send the link. I don't know. I just put the link up. How y'all not seeing it? There it is again. Bam. Y'all help me out. Where all my people at? Y'all help me out. I'm trying to do some work here. Tell them they're on the link. Tell them on the link right there. It says you good. All you gotta do is hit the link. I hope they can hear me. Jonathan, can you hear me, man? Jonathan Kwan, can you hear me? Yes? No? Maybe? I don't know. Yeah? You ain't here, so I don't know. What's up, Wayne? Hey, you know what? I'm trying to figure out how somebody said send me the link. They ain't in here, but they typing in here. I don't get that, but okay. I don't get that one. Y'all got me on that one. Okay, the room is filling up. All right, we'll give them a few more minutes, y'all. Come on, let's get on over here. Get on over here. Matter of fact, if y'all got any agencies, some agencies that need to be in here on this thing, send me a link. Rick, Wayne, none of y'all know who I'm talking about. Send a link. Tell them to get on over here. I mean, they already got some of this anyway, but they want to come over here and listen. Tell them to come on over here. Matter of fact, I know we recording, but tell them to get on over here. They need to know how many people are still trying to follow this thing. They ain't got to say nothing. Just tell them to follow it. Just tell them to come over here. Okay? Just tell them to come on over here. That's all I want to do. All right, y'all. We're going to get started here in a second. Give it 2 minutes. I'm trying to let people get in this room. I know they don't get the time zone. I know all the people in the FFG been told not to come over here, and PMC and TWP, and somebody tell Jonathan to go out and come back in. Y'all got to help me out now. I got a lot of work to do tonight. Come on now. Help me out. Tell Jonathan to go back out and come back in if he can't hear. Where my people at? Let me cut this damn thing off or something. All right. Y'all help me out now.
Thinking of a master plan. This ain't nothing but sweat inside my hands. So I dig it to my pocket, or my make 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 it to my pocket, or my
thinking of a master plan. This ain't nothing but sweat inside my hand. Oh my goodness, y'all don't know nothing about that. I think some of y'all are too young for that anymore. I mean, too old. No, too young. It's one of them. What's up, y'all? I'm glad y'all could be here. I really wouldn't want to bore y'all a whole lot. Just figure out to open the room a little early, try to get a lot more people over here. They'll start to come in. I'm probably going to repeat myself. Some people ain't going to like what I say. Some people going to love what I say. Some people still wonder, why am I doing it? Some people already know why I'm doing it. It don't matter. It don't matter. You don't run me. I don't run you. And I'm going to be the person that said that I was when I first started it. And that's just what it's going to be. All right. I still would like some music in the background, but I don't even want it to like dilute anything I'm saying or what I'm trying to do. So how y'all doing today? I am going to want some interaction between you, between us. OK, don't just come over here in the room being nosy. All right. Because there's a whole bunch. I don't know who, but it's a bunch of y'all in here just being nosy. All right. Because some of y'all being nosy, so you can go back and tell your group leaders that stole your money, and you can go tell Mike, and you can tell Ivan, you can go tell, it don't matter who you gonna tell, because guess what's gonna happen after you go tell what you finna go tell from what I said that you finna go tell, because that's what you feel like you want to go tell, because you just feel like telling, you won't be over here snooping because you feel like telling. Well, you gonna tell what you want. It don't even matter. A lot of these folks finna end up in jail, and I'm gonna tell you something. This is going to be personal. This is a personal message from me to you, for those in here that just feel like they just want to be over here just to be snooping because you believe and you're like, oh my God, that Sam was just saying so many things about this deal. It's just so untrue. Just let it happen in court. No. If somebody come rob you, would you want that to play out in court, or you want to know who robbed you first? You want to know who did it, right? You don't want to wait until trial and be like, okay, y'all let me know if it's real or not. You the one who got robbed. Don't you want to know? My goodness, man. Some of y'all so naive. Okay. But my personal message to those that don't believe that, you know, this is a scam. This is a scam. I just want to let y'all know. So for those that don't, I feel sorry for you. I really do. I really do. Not in the sense of that you believe because you were just trying to get your money, right? Because I wanted mine too. Everybody in here wanted their money. Everybody. So I'm not blaming that on you. We all fell for it. I was a fool just like you. Everybody hates a fool. So and we all was fools on this one. Whether you believe it or not, that's what we were or are. It's still going on. But don't be so gullible to the facts, right? Because we're going to break something down in here. We're going to break something down, then I'm going to show y'all. See, I don't want to show you first. I need to tell y'all something. And then I'm going to show you something going to rock every last one of y'all's world. And what I should have did, I should have sent it to my guy. He know who I'm talking to. We hit each other up from my G Uncensored group. I should have sent it to my guy just to give him an idea of what tonight's going to be about. But I won't shock the world, so let me do it. All right? Let's start with, I tell you what, first I'm going to ask y'all before I get into this. Is there anything that you guys want to know? Like, you got a question? Ask it right now before I get into this. I'm going to take like the top two or three questions. We're going to talk about it, which is going to set the tone for everything else, right? If you're a believer or a non-believer, it does not matter to me. You got a question? Ask it right now. What do you want to know right now? What do you want to know? Don't everybody type at once. If you don't want to know nothing, just I'll get on with the show. But what is it that you really want to know? Let's interact with each other tonight. We got to do that. It's important. Somebody type. What you got? This is why I like music in the background, but it's okay. Where is the money? Well, number one, it ain't in our banks, right? It ain't in our pockets. It's in a couple of places. Some of the group leaders got it. When did they think? Some of it went to Mike G. He did his thing. Some of it went to Gary or Neil, and they did their thing. And the rest in, I guess you could say, assets and bank accounts are sitting in, or it was Neil's property, and it is now confiscated. So that's where their money is. That's number one. What's the next question? That was a good one because it actually goes right into what I'm going to say. What's the next one? Where is the assets? Crypto. Woohoo! Now, first of all, those assets, which, you know, you're talking more like the cars, the buildings. First of all, the buildings are still where they're at. They couldn't pick the buildings up and put them in the impound, but they put them cars there. Okay? Those cars were, from everything I've ever known in the history of the law, everything that's confiscated is usually picked up, put in, especially a car, they're picked up, put in an impound at someone's impound lot. It could be the federal, state side, doesn't matter. It's being held right now. Okay? Whatever city or state that is, California or Vegas, right? They're collecting money on the assets that are being held in those lots. So I'm going to say this. We're losing money right now by those cars sitting in that lot. Number one, even if it was a $100,000 car, just for an example, even if it's a $100,000 car, it was probably worth, even if it don't have maybe 20,000 miles on it, because used cars right now are up because of everything's going on with those chips, but it doesn't matter. If it was a $100,000 car, probably around about 70,000, 60,000, and now it's sitting in a lot somewhere and it's going to be auctioned off, and it's probably going to be auctioned at around 30, 40 if it's a high-end vehicle, right? So as it's sitting there, right, getting daily fees, because some of these fees are, it depends on what city or state it is, it's 50, $100-something a day. As it's sitting there, those lots are going to have to get paid, which means what? We ain't gonna get no money from that. I'm just, it's gonna be pennies on the dollar. One more question. Anybody else got one? Oh, crypto? I'm not the crypto expert, but I feel that that's gone. Who in here knows something about crypto? I think y'all know that part is gone. It's a couple. I think some of us didn't talk about that before. I own Mike Jensen's group and some people in my chat. The crypto part is gone. You know, especially when some of the stuff was bought with crypto, like the cars or whatever, even some of the homes, I don't know. And, you know, being sold for cash, like the Teslas. Okay. So I'm telling you, there ain't no telling you that. I mean, you can't get inside, be trying to find out nothing about that. Blockchain is on lock, but that's just where that's at. So if you had crypto, I'm sorry, man. From what I've been hearing, that's a done data. You know what I mean? That's a done data. All right. So not to hurt anybody's feelings on that, but I'm not the big crypto guy, but I've heard from a lot of my crypto people like, nah, that's a done data. That's going to be a hard one. All right. I see somebody else typing right quick. Let me answer this question. We're going to get to this thing right quick. So I got to tell y'all something. I'll be typing all day. Was Linda not handpicked by Mike G? From my understanding, they've been friends a very long time. Now, I got friends that I've been knowing 5, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, you know, a lot of years. And if one of my friends do something crazy, I'll cuss him out. We'll cuss her out. Or if I do something crazy, they'll cuss me out. That's what friends do. But Mike has told me, and I got proof of that, that she was stupid, ignorant, or whatever the word it was, stupid or ignorant. It was one of them. And, you know, he didn't trust her. Now, that could have been his way of telling me that, you know, because Linda may have had something on him. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I don't know. I don't know. You know, so, I mean, he talked about her behind her back, too, to me. So just like he's probably, and not no probably, just like he's talking to everybody else behind my back and they joining him with it, I don't really care because I'm only showing you guys the truth. And that's the part that they never wanted out. So, but that's just that. And did he take money in? I don't know, Carol, if Cal took any money in. I'm going to be straight up. I've had a lot of conversations with Cal. I don't know if he took money in. I just know he was helping her with FPS. And y'all, what is it? Financial Protection Services. Am I right? And that's what they were doing. And they wanted me involved in that. Right? I'm talking about Sam. They wanted Sam involved in that. Same way PMC wanted me in their group bad as hell, which they ain't gonna tell all their people in PMC that. They'll never tell y'all that, but I got proof of it and I showed it last week, a week and a half ago, from text messages from discarding them. So I don't need to lie about that. Yeah, it's a whole bunch of stuff I've heard about Glenda. I ain't gonna put it on here right now because I don't even feel like talking about that chick. I just heard a whole bunch of horrible mess about a whole bunch of people. That was crazy. That was crazy. So let me get to it. I told you I was going to answer a few of them, but let me tell y'all this right quick. Let me get to it. All right. So obviously, hold on. Let me click this to make sure that you guys. Okay. Y'all can hear me. Just one person say yes and I can keep going. Y'all hear me? Okay. I want to tell y'all something. We're not important. Nope. We're not. We are not important. There are tens and tens of thousands of people in this deal, and we are not important. And I'm going to tell you why we're not important, or why I feel that way. How about that? We're not important because FFG had a call this past weekend, and they wanted all their members over there, which all of them didn't go. And they said a lot of things, or he said, that him or them, the ones that were talking, said a lot of things over there. But here's the thing. They wanted it so private that they didn't give a darn about all the other partners in this deal. This is one of the things that I've been having a problem with since this deal has been in existence, or at least when I found out, because I thought everybody was working together. But obviously, all the group leaders up until right now, now all of a sudden they want to work together because Sam and the Mike G Uncensored group been at their butt, and the SEC and FBI and DOJ is at their tail. Y'all see how I'm trying not to curse? So now all of a sudden, PMC and everybody else is on the FFG calls when they don't even be on the folks' call. Now all of a sudden they want to hold hands and sing Kumbaya, me Lord. Now they want to do all that now. Don't cry to the Lord now. Don't run to each other's aid now. I've been trying to get y'all together since early in the year. Now all of a sudden all of y'all in trouble. Now all y'all want to be together on your little Zooms and private calls and da da da. Man, come on, man. Come on, man. So we're not important enough for them to do a major Zoom call for all the partners to come on. They just want it just for them so they can fool a few people over there. It ain't working. Not in all totality, anyway. It's not working. People have awakened. And they're not going to take this mess from these group leaders anymore. I'm getting all the calls, the texts, the emails, and the private messages about how stupid the group leaders are sounding right now, trying their best to keep people from doing chargebacks and to get them to sign petitions. Man, y'all sound real stupid. Y'all think these people couldn't think for themselves. That's why I said, y'all, we're not important, because FFG feel like we're not important enough to have a Zoom call. And he go in there and tell everybody. He wanted to keep it to them, to the, you know, to his people. But he didn't even get all his people. Ain't that something? You had something so important to say that all your people didn't show up? I didn't tell everybody not to come to yours, but y'all telling them not to come to mine. So if mine is real minuscule, that's fine, because the word's going to get out anyway. So let's jump to this major issue of Cola saying that he spoke to Gary. Wow. He spoke to Gary. Gary told him there wasn't no old man coming from South Korea or wherever he was coming from, or Jupiter, to meet Neil in Hawaii. Now, hold the hell up now. What? Wait a minute. What? So you mean to tell all the partners right now, even those that were listening to this dude, this Nigerian cat, tell everybody that he spoke to Gary, and Gary said that never happened? Everybody that was in that room should have cussed his donkey out right then. They should have unmuted their mics and said everybody in that room should have went off immediately. But y'all, not me. I'm sorry, you know. Y'all, not me. Because if I was in that room when he said he spoke to Gary, and said that that never happened, but it was actually some dude in California. That was one of the biggest red flags that they ever could have mentioned. If y'all want to make comments, y'all can. Okay, I see the screen. Y'all want to make comments? Go ahead. Okay. Taking COVID tests every time to go to Hawaii to meet the old man. So you mean to tell me it never happened? And he let that cat out the bag. If that part right there, just that one, did not wake everybody in FFG and PMC and TWP and LMWOP and all, if that didn't wake y'all up right then, I don't know what to tell you. But the plot thickens. So we're gonna go a little bit farther. The man or the old man was never in Hawaii in a satellite office. So what was he doing in Hawaii? Oh, my fault. He didn't really go. Oh, you know why he never went? The same reason why he never went to New York. There was no deal. And if Rudy had bought a car from him earlier when he was supposed to have been going to Hawaii, we would have known that then. But he was supposed to have been in New York, but it was still ended up in Cali and ran into somebody that was in the Mike G deal that knew who he was once he saw that paperwork and said, Neil, I'm in the deal. Then there went the issue. Oh, crap. Now, somebody says, and do you have any reason to doubt his retail of what Gary said? I'm going to tell you this right here. You got a man that has thousands of whatever members, and he tells them that on a Zoom call? That he spoke with Gary? Someone who's supposed to be a man in the cloak. So much love God, so much. And you and y'all really think that he was going to go over there and tell them that if that didn't happen? He told them exactly his conversation with Gary. There's no reason to believe that he did not talk to Gary. Oh, my goodness. Come on, man. If he said he spoke to Gary, he spoke to Gary. He wasn't on there to tear the deal up. He was on that call to make everybody, hey, we need to sign a petition, and this ain't that. You know what else they told him? This is a conspiracy against Neil. A conspiracy? This is a scam, not a conspiracy. So he wasn't there to down the deal. He was there to support it by telling everybody, yeah, guess what, y'all? I spoke with Gary. And he said, well, that was a little miscommunication. There was no old man in Hawaii. He was actually in California. Oh, really? So why was Mike telling everybody this for the last year or so? But Mike said he got the information from you, Gary, that supposedly had gotten it from Neil, Gary, which now comes out of Coach Cola's mouth. Y'all still want to be naive? You still want to be dumb? I'm going to call you what you are. I don't have a problem with that. I've been called a whole lot of names, so if I can take it, you can take it. You still want to be dumb? Okay, let's keep going. Let's keep going, because I got something to show y'all in a minute. Let's keep going. So there's a conspiracy. No old man in Hawaii, because he was actually in California. So that means Neil could have met the man in California? He could have actually met him in California? But you just told us he kept going to Hawaii? Oh, my goodness. And oh, did y'all hear this one? I gotta say this. Wait a minute, where my paper? Hold on, y'all. Oh, hold on. Here's it. I got them right here. Yeah, there you go. Woo. Okay. I told y'all, and he just had to say this. I told y'all this. I've been telling y'all this for months, all year long. They've been selling trust over there. It ain't no good. I'm going to ask y'all the question. How many of y'all got a trust over there in Coach Cola's camp? How many of y'all did? Come on. Don't lie. Don't be bashful. We ain't got nothing to hide in here. I got that same trust. I just didn't get it from him. I got it from Tamron them from the same company. Hold up. Come on. Tell the truth right now. How many of y'all got that trust from Cola and them over there? Y'all need to holler at me, man. Don't lie either. How many of y'all got that trust? Talk to me. Oh, they told the whole FFG not to come over here. They block everybody to come over here. Huh? How many of y'all ordered that trust for Coach Cola and them over there? If y'all didn't, y'all was smart, and I'm glad you did, because I should have been smart like y'all. But I was just brand new in the deal, and folk knew it. Get this trust. We took that trust to Bank of America. We took it to Frost Bank, BBVA, and Truist. We took that trust. That same trust. Y'all know the Bank of America met us in Chili's, y'all. We were in Chili's with three of their top officials, their wealth management team. Me and my boy Chris and our family. We met them in Chili's in Dallas. We gave them the trust. They hit us back a week later because their legal department looked over their whole thing. They came back and said, we cannot open this account. This account does not reflect what you are wanting. We were like, why not? They gave it to us. Like, what's not? I said, so what do we need to change? They couldn't tell us what to change. That it's not their job. So we go back to the drawing board. We talked to one of our buddies who got the same trust. He had somebody else that was out of state, Alabama, Georgia, something like that, and said, hey, man, change this on their trust, man. Yeah, it's all messed up. We changed it on the trust. We took both our trust back. Okay? We took both our trust back. They said it again. No, they even put us on a Zoom call with an attorney and the team. Because remember, the deal was supposed to close so fast. Over that June, July, we was trying to hurry up and get our stuff done. Not this past. I'm talking about this last year, June, July. Not this year. Last year, June, July. That's how long this old crap trust been around. They had a Zoom call with an attorney. We had to go talk to another attorney on the Zoom because, you know, it's COVID stuff going on. So, you know, couldn't go in the offices. No, this is not working. What do we need to do? What you guys need to do is going to cost you $10,000. What? That trust is garbage. It doesn't protect you from any. That thing is over. It's four banks told us this. Two different lawyers. Then we get Novipak on the phone, attorney Novipak, I apologize, on a Zoom call, and attorney Novipak told everybody to run far away from that thing if possible. But he said that he spoke with the SEC. I'm not making this up. I am not making this up. He spoke with the SEC. He trying to be hard. What do you want from me? Yes, he say, hey, well, this is what we want. You gonna give it to us or not? Well, what do you want from me? I'm cooler over here, okay? I'm FFG. What do you want? Are you going to attempt to comply or not? That's what he kept telling people. What he kept telling people, he kept talking crap to the SEC, right? Well, he's supposed to have been some financial expert. Okay, whatever. So they didn't ask him any more questions. They was like, are you going to, what you going to do? You, all we want to know is, are you going to comply or not? Well, give me a little time. How much time you need? Well, give me. Guess what? He complied. You know why he complied? Because if he hadn't, he knew they was coming. He won't sit on the phone with y'all or the FFG folk and got them all the dummy PMC dummies all over there listening like he running things. Dude, ain't nothing you can do with the alphabet folks. Nothing. 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 Get up. You sound like you all bad on the phone, man. Get up, stop lying to these people. Then he gonna say some mess about, crumbs. Says that the money that is crumbs. Don't worry about these crumbs. Dude, these folks' monies are not crumbs. It's not. Some of these people put their life savings in there. You telling them it's crumbs? Well, since you think they're crumbs, what about the crumbs that you took from them for these trusts that they can't do nothing with? You trying to make them think that you got a trust that's so cold and you got all the members of FFG up under that trust? Did they agree to that? Did they sign some papers? Did they do anything? You got them up under a trust? Let me tell you something, bro. Your trust don't work in all 50 states. Y'all better wake up. Do y'all know what happens at the beginning of that trust? There's this whole disclaimer up there. There's a disclaimer up there that tells you that they are not attorneys and blah, 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 blah. And this thing doesn't work, then go get you an attorney. Y'all think I'm lying? Don't make me show you because you know I will. The stuff that they got all at the beginning, it talks about all this stuff about this trust and what they are and what they are not. And basically, if you got any problems, they suggest you go hire an attorney. What? I thought you was the legal. Okay. Whew. Y'all, I can't make this stuff up. I'm sorry. I can't make this stuff up. This is what's going on. And it got you fooled. So let's keep going. So he says that their bank account was subpoenaed from Chase. And that they subpoenaed and they shows how much they took in, how much went out, and how much it went and who it went to. Can I ask y'all a question? Where's the money from Zelle, PayPal, Cash App, and Venmo then? Can anybody answer that? You said the money from the Chase account. What about these others? What about the others? When someone sends you something from Chase, you got to take it out of there in order to go from Cash App. You got to take it out of there to go put it in some other account. You got to take it away from PayPal to go put it in another account unless you got that card, debit card attached to it, which means it went to your personal account. I don't think y'all following this. Just because it showed how much went in, what about that did not show up that went in? This is what I'm going to tell y'all. Now all of a sudden, they know that they have to show records of everything, and they better not lie on none of these documents because they're going to go deeper into where that money came from. So they tried to use a play of words to put a little fear in everybody, trying to tell them, hey, they're going to want to know where y'all got the money to. The SEC ain't looking at nobody but the group leaders, Mike, Neil, Gary. They ain't looking at y'all. They don't give a damn. Excuse my friend. They don't care where y'all got that money from. They ain't talking about that. You put a couple hundred dollars in, $1,000, them folks probably know you already work. They're not worried about that. They want to know what came in for real. So remember, I asked them, hey, y'all got a right to know what came in to each one of these groups. So tell them to show you a spreadsheet, blot out everybody's email and phone number, contact stuff. And as you go down that Excel spreadsheet, go to your name. When you see your name, go all the way across and see, does it match to the amount that you put in? If it does, you good. But there's a trick. There's a trick. If you had the time, or if we all just had the time, which I would, me and a bunch of us would, go all the way over to the right to your total. And then total the amount yourself if everybody's stuff was correct. And then look at the bottom number. And if those numbers are off, that means they were adding it up wrong on purpose, just to show the total at the bottom, because they don't think no one's going to go through their paperwork. No one's there to audit any one of them. Nobody. They're doing their own auditing. Mike was never going to audit them. Never. So they just said whatever those bottom numbers are. They could do what they want because it's going to their personal account. If I had to hand it that dude $100,000, how do I know he put it all in there? Because he took money from probably another 1,000 people that gave him 20, 30, 40s, and 50s. So he could shave 20 off of me, because in the end, I don't know who the other people are, and I don't know how much they put in. But when I go to see over here, like, dang, we raised $3 million, I'm pretty sure my money in there. When all in actuality, they raised $5 million. All right, man, I'm done with that part. Let's get back more into what the whole deal is. Y'all can keep listening to Coach Cola all you want to. Okay, keep doing it. Any questions before I go any further? Because they say Neil ain't got y'all money. That's what Cola told all the people in FFG. Why is we after Neil? He didn't do nothing to us. We gave our money over to Mike G. Well, Mike G gave the money to Neil. So what do you mean? You feel me? What do you mean? He didn't do nothing. He the one who got the money. Oh, you know how you know the money was given to Neil? Mike said so in an email, and I got it. Ooh, y'all didn't know that, did you? I'm finna show it to you. Yeah. See, I ain't talking stuff over here. I got proof. And I'm finna get ready to show it to you. And I'm going to actually show you what Neil said. Let me paint the picture for you. There was a conversation that was going on. It had to do with the Mike G and Sensor Group. And, you know, I'm playing chess, not checkers. Okay. And Neil is telling me things, but Mike didn't know. Well, Mike knew that he was CCing me. Mike hit him up and told him, don't be adding people. Basically, hey, if I were you, I wouldn't be. Hey, Neil, if I was you, I wouldn't be putting other people on the emails. And Neil told him, nah, I only put you and Sam in here, who was in the whole Mike G thing. And then he went off up into something called sales. Do you know what the sales are? Anybody? I'm just asking a question. Anybody want to know what the sales are? I'm going to help you out in a minute, but I'm going to ask a question. Anybody know what the sales are? Anybody, please, come on. Y'all interact with your boy. I'm trying to get y'all something, man. Talk to me. Don't have me over here by myself. I won't come over here no more. Pretty much. The sales were us. He says, no, no, I don't want to go by nothing. No, here, say, see, say. Y'all know how I do things. Let me get ready to go share my screen. Let me pull up this email. Boom, there they all go. I saved them right there for y'all. Wait a minute. I got to pull it up another way. But I got to share the screen with y'all first. Let's see. Let's share the screen. Y'all got to let me know when y'all see my screen, okay? Y'all got to let me know, so please interact. Don't just have me over here by myself, okay? Let me know when y'all see it. Do y'all see the screen yet? I told y'all I'm going to help y'all out. I told y'all I'm going to help y'all out. Come on, y'all. It's up on my end. Why y'all don't see it? Y'all don't see the screen? More than one person. One person says no. No, y'all still don't see the screen. Okay, you see the screen. Y'all see the screen. Okay. All right, I'm finna say. All right, y'all see the screen. All right. Now, for y'all that don't see my screen, I don't know what to tell y'all, but I tried. Okay? All right. Let me go right here. Do y'all see that? Y'all see the emails? Do y'all see that? Y'all gotta let me know every time I switch the screen, okay? That's what I'm saying. I switch. Y'all see the email thing? Do y'all see it? Come on. I need y'all to answer. Okay. Let me go right. I don't know. I'm gonna go right here. Okay. This was in May. I've been talking to Neil a little bit before this, but I'm just going, I ain't going to go to all the email. Hey, everyone. I want the clue. Oh, I'm trying to make sure this is the right one. I agree. Normal behavior. Yes, I agree. He was talking about the school exception. No, that's another guy. Okay. Wrong one. I don't mind showing y'all stuff. I ain't got nothing to hide. I ain't got shit to hide over here. All right. Let's see if this one of them. Okay, Mike asked me to gay. Okay, look, now I want y'all, okay, here it is. Y'all see this? I'm showing y'all certain, I ain't gonna, you know, do everything, you know, go through everything. I'm just showing y'all something. This is, hold on, so y'all will know that I'm not lying. This is from Neil, okay? Some people be talking about. This is from Neil to Reach for the Sky, March call, region. It's urgent, okay? It's urgent, okay? Just want to let y'all know, all right? Just want to let you know. Mike asked me through Gary to not communicate with his people, okay? Gary is with me, and I've passed him your number. Thanks for your help. Mike asked me through Gary not to communicate with his people. Well, it was already too late. He's already talking to me. But Mike did not know at the time that Neil was talking to me. And Neil didn't want him to know until he got ready to send him this other email that you guys are going to get in a minute. Okay? But I had no problem. I said, okay, no problem. Thanks for letting me know. I figured since that we made contacts, you know, through Telegram with you, at least one other person preventing people from the attorney general and media outlets will get a call. Mike's a great guy and we talk, but there has to be more done. All right. And look at this. And my ideas have to be put out in place or it's going to be a storm. My name, my address, personal information been put there as well. I'm protecting you. Now, look now, I'm such a bad guy, but watch this now. I'm protecting you, Gary, Mike, Colin, and our wives from all of this and da, da, da. This is what I'm telling you. I'm doing all this damn protecting. Y'all ain't doing nothing to protect me. Ain't none of them did nothing to protect Sam. Not now. Okay? All right. So he said, I really don't understand how the haters instantly has reached this level. He showed me a link. Oh, no, that's the wrong one. Let's talk soon. Hold up. I'm trying to get to something, y'all. this Telegram. Okay. Hold on. I've been on here since it started. Da-da-da. Oh, they have. Oh, this is what I want y'all to see. Some of the other stuff don't. They have succeeded in draining our already limited bandwidth. My take is that they have refunded a chargeback and now can't stand the supporters for the supporters to succeed by any means necessary. Mike added us to this target list when he shared our name officially. That right there, what I want y'all to see. Mike added us to the target list when he shared our name officially. Let me tell you why that's important. How many of y'all remember? I know Mike G on Censor People here. How many of y'all remember this whole thing about Mike and Gary not really supposed to been having no contact? How many of y'all remember that? Talk to me over here. How many of y'all remember that? They ain't supposed to have no contact. Don't nobody remember. Nobody's typing. This is what I'm talking about. Okay. Y'all remember that? No? Okay. Oh, well. Now I'm getting messages from others in the group, although they could be the same guy. He could be even posed as one, and someone is assessed clearly and has mental issues. Okay. I'm trying to get to something. Trying to get to something. I think for this to provide, hold up. Trying to get to something. I forgot where it was, so y'all give me a second. Here's me taking everybody from Cousin Trey Show. Okay, that's just making clear authority. News growing the charity partners with the change zero seven stage shipping being put. Oh, this is what I told him. This is what I told him. I said, Neil, with all this going on and the traffic with partners trying to reach the attorney generals in several states, shouldn't it be important to just close it out? Now I'm asking questions because I already know I'm trying to figure out what the hell really going on. If not, it may destroy this. I understand legalities and support your decision. I'm holding these people off and it's hard. Let me know. He says, that's a whole other topic to discuss with your people and maybe Gary. The updated plan for recognizing contributions is commencing this week with a written update. You will likely be receiving excerpts. Hold on. Now, I really need to make sure. I need to see who's paying attention. Somebody, please, can y'all do this for me? Can someone look up the word excerpts and tell me what that means? If you don't already know. Somebody give me the definition of you will be likely receiving excerpts. Somebody please go to the Google and post it, please. There's a reason why I'm telling y'all this, because it's something y'all ain't getting that's been out that y'all still ain't paying attention to. I'm gonna give y'all a few seconds. Come on, somebody is real fast with typing. Somebody, I'm not gonna do nothing else until we find that out. Thank you, Carol. Thank you. Thank you. Excerpts are an extraction of what I've already said or done. Film, music, or something like that. Am I right? I'm asking the question. Am I right? Okay. Whew, this is good. This is going to go over every last one of y'all heads, except for those that know what I'm talking about. So, Neil, the excerpts, where did it come from? Uh-oh, I don't think y'all caught that. Did y'all catch that? I don't think you caught it. Where did the excerpts come from? No, it didn't come from Mike. Y'all know, it ain't hit you yet? It ain't hit you yet? Where did it come from? No, not even Gary. Where did it come from? Nobody knows. Oh my God, I'm going to tell you. The excerpts came from the other group. Y'all don't get it? It came from the other group. The other group that was just like us. The one where he was actually talking to those people, he wasn't talking to us. The videos that Neil was doing never were meant for us. They were meant for his other group. That's why Neil and Mike were never really supposed to come into a hell of a connection, because people would have put that together and it would have blew up a long time ago. It was for his other people. I done lost y'all. Yeah, I lost y'all. I'm sorry. They were giving updates out somewhere else other than us. And those excerpts came from there to Mike, which he then doctored and put and made himself. That dude ain't wrote all this stuff all by himself. He had a format he was following. Man, come on, man. I don't even want to talk to moms. Whew. Okay. All right. Okay. Let me get to this. Yeah, he sent me all this. This is Neil. He sent me all this too. So anyway. What did I say here? Partners all over the world are seeing this. Partners all over the world are seeing this and are hurting because of this. Make your report. Now that way I stop it. Hey, when you see Gary again, I would love to speak with him and Mike just to get some kind of strategy for what's going on. Let me know. If it happens, it happens. If not, if not. Yeah, the other group know now. Oh, well, some of them do anyway. So, I don't have any plans currently. Based on the latest status, no one wants to touch verse. Did you just hear that? Hold on. No, you heard me, but I want y'all to read that. No one wants to touch verse. Haters one, supporters zero. Did y'all just see that? Did you? It's right here. You right, Carol? Boom. Listen, this was in May. This is a whole month and a half before this man got arrested. I ain't even done. When I get to this other part, I think y'all just gonna hang it down. Excuse my friend. I think y'all just gonna hang up and be like, I'm done. It's over. I'm climbing the mountain. Okay? Just hold up. No one wants to touch verse. You know why? So your John Sally's and all your Cubes and everybody that he had all out there, nah, no folks got real attorneys. It was a lot of folk probably told him, don't touch that. I even told him, damn it, I support you. Okay. Here's the thing. Here's a couple of things I said. I said, is the deal real? This is what people ask me. I said, deal real? I answer yes simply because of what Mike says and what you're doing that is relative to this invention and verse. And we can hear about things from your videos, and also others who are investors have said it. Because I remember now, I know at least, well, two of the millionaires. The other one, I know through a lady that knows somebody. I know the other one through somebody else that I've talked to. All right. So I asked, why does it keep changing? That part has to be explained to the masses by Mike and back it up with facts. Yeah, I was backing up the people. But none of this stuff right here is important. So this is what he says. I can't speak to any deal. I can only represent that a company is real, all right? This is the crux of the problem. People have no concept that any deal is based upon certain criteria and conditions.
One of the major conditions was sales, which have ground to a halt. So I'm not sure what people can be expecting. The sales was ground to a halt. I want y'all to remember that phrase right there. Remember that phrase, sales which have ground to a halt. Okay. I told him, just preaching to me, brother. I don't know. I don't want any information about the deal. I know you can't speak on. I know the deal is real. There are qualified partners that there are unqualified partners that never should have been in this deal. That's why we are here. And the fact that some of them so-called leaders did things unbecoming. And I was talking to Neil about these bastards. Okay. I said, I'm just here to help. And it's a hard ass job. It's right here. Playing chess, not checkers. Okay, so watch this. Gary's number, one thing for sure. I told him I already had Gary's number, blah, 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 blah. Boom. Now we're going to get to some meat. Let's get to some meat. Is that it? Hold on, let me make sure. Twitter account, no, same, nah, 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 nah. I want to say something, nah, 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 nah. Thank you for your input. I am a bit in an awkward situation because Mike is one of the main day communication with his members, yet they are contacting me. I'm trying to make sure this is the right one. Do you agree to work on your support? Regardless, I hope you appreciate your opinion more of legal standpoint, seeking clarity on sales. Okay, no, that's not the one. It must be this other one. Where is it at? Is it right here? Hold on. I'm trying to find it for you. Let me see if this one of them. Ah, this is about the little news and verse. Hold up. I'm finna give it to you, man. I'm finna tell you what I'm saying. What to say. Oh, there it is right there. All right, y'all. This is what I was trying to get to. This is what I was trying to get to. So here y'all go, man. If you don't think this thing is a scam by now, if you don't think that this was a whole plot, let me help you out. So this is Neil. This is May 31st. Almost, well, 30 days, 29 days before he got arrested. Okay. He says, this is getting so old, they're just trying to annoy. I said exactly, there's nothing to do, da, 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 just let them rant, blah, blah, blah. All right, here we go. Neil says, what? Their actions have caused our PayPal and banks to be shut down. So there has been consequence. I don't dismiss the harm they have done to us all, including themselves, if they have indeed remained involved for a payout. I told him I had a plan, but it was going to take him, Gary, and all of us to talk. But for some reason, we couldn't do that because they, all three of them, were not going to be on that call with me because for some reason, Neil ain't supposed to be on this call at all. So I want y'all to pay attention. Remember, I told y'all to pay attention to something about a halt. Listen at this, y'all. I'm going to read this whole thing. It's not a lot. June 1st, 8:38 a.m. This was early. We having conversations. Remember, 8:38 a.m. I have refrained from replying to these emails as per your wishes, but we are about to go under and you haven't delivered sales in 8 months. Let me help y'all out right quick. Count back from this month backwards and you tell me what month that is. I'll be waiting. What month is that? 8 months from today. Remember, you got to count this one and go back. What is it? Well, June. I mean June, not August, but June. Count 8 months from June and go backwards. What month is that? You haven't had sales in 8 months. So that means the 9th month was the ending of the sale month. Thank you, Danny girl. Thank you, Danny girl. Thank you. My 500 challenge is, I think, my 500 challenge is Gary. If y'all didn't know that, that's his new email. I don't know if y'all got that or not. Anyway, so listen to me. Y'all thought I was playing. No, not 8 months from today. I'm talking about 8 months from when this email from June 1st, 8 months ago, if you counting it right, it's October, was the last month that they took in any money publicly. I told y'all in the other email, remember the word sales and who they were. The sales were us. You haven't had any sales in 8 months. People are asking when the deal will close, and I cannot ignore them. He's talking to Mike G and Gary. Listen, I'm going to show it to you. Hold up. What? I was acting. Look at it. Look. I ain't lying to you. Here it is right here. It's to Gary, to Mike, and to me. We're the only ones on his email. He's responding to Mike and Gary. Okay? I have refrained from replying to those emails per your wishes, but we are about to go under, and you haven't delivered sales for 8 months. 29 days later, 28 days later, he's locked up. People are asking when the deal will close, and I cannot ignore them. We have lost bank accounts, PayPal, staff, and social media prominence, and I, for one, cannot risk my freedom by acknowledging any. Somebody tell me what that last word say. Somebody please tell me what that last word say. I'm not going to even say it because somebody might say I put the word in y'all mouth. Tell me what that last word say. I cannot risk my freedom by acknowledging what? Y'all tell me what it say. I ain't saying nothing. The man was trying not to risk his freedom by acknowledging that there was ever a deal because he knew he would have been in trouble. God damn it. I told y'all I had the information. I told y'all to stop it. Oh my God. I have made representations in the video, and those are to the extent of the company's representations to all its stakeholders. They were not talking about us. The video was not for us. Remember, Mike G never even got the video. It took me, somebody in Mike G Uncensored, or some other partner to actually show everybody the doggone thing. And then somebody sent it to Mike, and then he put it out the next day and said, here is the video. He never even got it. God dog it, man. Y'all ain't listening. Brother, you saying you knew all this back then but kept it a secret. No, bro. Remember, chess, not checkers. I'm getting all my information. If I put a halt to everything right now, I never get to Mike G's home. You see that now? If I stop it all right now, I never get to his house to get the other information. I've been doing this for a long time, y'all. I've been doing this. You feel what I'm saying, bro? That's what I'm trying to tell you. I don't know what you expect me to tell these people, but they are contacting and harassing anyone and everyone that they can. I did not sign up for this with you. Who is he talking to, y'all? Who he say he didn't sign this up? Who he say I didn't sign up for this with y'all? Who is he talking to? He talking to Mike and Gary. The two fools that turned him in. Y'all don't get, come on, man. They turned him in. He was fed up. It's done. They was finna get ready. They like, oh, I'm paraphrasing this. So this is what Neil talking about now? Well, look, man, we're going to do something about this. This fool going crazy. Well, we're going to do something. And then they went to them people. Okay, watch this. Hold up. Remember now, this at 8:38. I ain't done. This at 8:38 a.m. Y'all thought I was playing? look, this is what happened. I got to go past it so y'all can see the response. This is what Mike sent him. He says, hi, Neil. Not wise to copy other people on this message. That's it. That said, I have only ever told my loan partners what I have been told. Like three anticipated closing dates that never happened. Also, I have lost as much as you have or more. You have received all the money. Beverly, you remember you asked that question when you said, who got the money? Remember I told you I was going to tell you? You remember? Look, I told you. I got it right here. And Gary and I and a lot of others are counting on you, Neil. Perhaps this will help your attitude. He talks about people supporting it and da da, but watch this. He says, we can't control what others have to say and blah, 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 blah. And I didn't care about that. So remember, he said, Mike sent that at 7 something. That's when this email came. That's when this one. So watch this. Do anybody know what BCC mean? Do you see that? I'm trying to show. Do you guys know what? I got to know because I know I got intelligent people here. I just got to make sure that y'all are still with me. Do y'all know what BC? Anybody tell me what BCC means in the email, please? For those that may not know. Anybody? Blind copy. Look what Neil did after Mike sent him an email back with the 1, 2, 3, 4 of us on that email thread. Mike says, if I were you, I wouldn't put others. So Neil said, I got something for your ass. Because I trust Sam, I'm going to still make sure Sam get this information. So what does he do? Blind copy Sam. And he says this so they wouldn't know I got it. I was actually directing at Gary and copying you and Sam, the only other member of the email chain from Rick's group that I have had any contact with, because he have had contact with the Mike G Uncensored, me. He wasn't talking to nobody. He was talking to my homegirl who was in my group, but as far as everybody else know, he was only talking to me, Rick, a couple other, handful of people. Everybody didn't know it. Now, everybody didn't know all this because I had shared it with nobody. All right? I did hear, by the way, you actually apologized to Rick, which would only embolden him more. Y'all remember that. So, the reality is this. I want y'all to pay attention. You can keep on letting these people play with you, but I want y'all to pay attention. The reality is that without sales, revenues, not only will there be no close, there go that word again, there will be no company. We are in liquidation mode at present, trying to right the ship, cannibalizing potentially multi-billion dollar business arms to survive. This hurts our mutual valuation terribly. Now, let me tell y'all something right quick. Let me ask y'all. If y'all was Mike or Gary and Neil sent this to y'all, when he said this hurts our mutual valuation terribly, if you was one of them, wouldn't y'all turn his ass in? Even though you're part of the crook too and take an immunity deal, think about that for a minute. I'm going to let that sizzle in y'all spirits. Come on, talk to me. Talk to me. Y'all been wanting to find out. Y'all got people telling y'all I'm crazy and ignorant and dumb and all about my kids and stuff. They want to do all that. I'm the one with all the information. My question is, can I get my money back from them shirts and wristbands? Slick Jones, you ain't getting nothing back for no wristbands. And if you already got your shirts, go wear them or get out of my room. We ain't in here talking about no shirts and wristbands. We didn't already. You obviously wasn't on the call when I showed everybody the proof about the shirts and wristbands. So I'm not here to talk about you. You're irrelevant. Okay. If you do indeed have a majority of supporters, we should consider allowing them to step in and protect Gary's stake, in which is by your extension. Did y'all just hear that? Did you just hear that? I don't think y'all understood it. This is why Neil got in trouble. This is why he got in trouble. If you do indeed have a majority of supporters, we should consider allowing them to step in and protect Gary's stake, which by extension is your own. That means he's saying, look, go ahead and tell all your supporters to drop some more money and buy out Gary's stake. That's more sales. Slick Jones, bye. Some people are just dumb, and I'm going to call you that to your face. I'm just letting you know it. Ain't no punk over here. I'm going to call you dumb to your face. Will, if you're talking about real business, you're talking about shirt and wristband. That just showed everybody how low your IQ is. So holler at your boy. Now, another option which I wish I could find easily is someone to buy out Gary's position the same way he tried to buy out the Canadians, but which they came to learn through your disclosures and therefore prevented. Do y'all understand that statement? I don't know. Do y'all understand that statement? I need somebody to answer that. Do y'all understand that statement? Because I'm going to tell y'all something, once again, that gives a whole lot more validity than what I've been trying to tell y'all. And that is this. Another option, which I wish could easily is someone to buy out Gary's position the same way he tried to buy out the Canadians. Gary tried to buy the Canadians out. He tried to stab them in the back. But they found out through the disclosures of Neil and it going more public. And so it didn't happen. He was going to screw them. He's going to screw them over. Okay. I have outlined collateralized bridge loan opportunity and shared it with the stakeholders of which Gary is one. I urge you to consider supporting as I feel this is our final month. Hold up. Did you hear me? Y'all didn't know this. This is our final month considering chapter 7 and 11 proceedings, which bring with them a host of issues for all involved. He's saying, if y'all don't do something, I'm going to go and file this chapter 7-11, and it's going to be a whole bunch of shit. And I'm sorry, y'all, I had to say that because that's exactly what he just told Mike and Gary. Ergo, the reason why they went on and flipped the script. Oh, we're going to have to do an immunity deal on this thing. Man, this dude crazy. We've been involved in this long. He talking about doing all this. There it is. Okay. All right. I just thought I'd share this with y'all. Y'all thought I was playing around here. Y'all got questions? Holler at your boy. That's what we finna do. Holler at your boy. Holler at me. Y'all got some questions before we get out of here? Because I called myself trying to give y'all all the information that you needed. So that you can help your friends out, your family out. Well, Robin, here's the thing. He was involved in it. Okay. Now I'm going to use me and you as an example. Say me and you both are involved in a scam. Yet I don't get from you out of the scam what was promised to me as well. Even though I've skimmed off the top and I got all this stuff going on over here and I've had all this money come through my account, you finna renege on me. So guess what I'm going to do before you renege on me? I'm going to go get me an immunity deal and I'm going to work with the state against you. Y'all keep believing all this stuff because right now Mike is working with the state against Neil. He's not working for Neil. There's a reason why he keep trying to tell y'all and these group leaders, hey, y'all go ahead on and keep on doing this and this and this and that. Don't let them do them chargebacks. Y'all need to keep them calm and cool over there because, God dog, I'm trying to get my money from Neil. I'm trying to get my charge back. So, Robin, if me and you was in that deal together and you locked up in jail, I got lawyers and I got enough money to go after my money that I sent you as well, which came from all these people that we done duped out of this money. And if the bank can give me at least 60 to 70 to 85% of that money, I got millions. But I got to stop the group leaders and tell them to tell the people, stop bothering me because I'm trying to get my money, but don't nobody know it. And on top of that, I could have, which I can't say, but I can almost, I ain't too far off on a lot of stuff. So whatever these group leaders is trying to do, because the hammer coming down, the SEC is not the only one that's going to be involved. When it becomes criminal, that's when the FBI and the DOJ steps in. They think it's just all SEC. Mm-mm. As soon as the SEC is done with you, you're going to have another court case if they already don't know it now. And if they were smart, they'd already know it. Okay? Some of them ain't. Y'all got some dummy group leaders, not all 100% of them, and some subgroup leaders. They are dumb. I ain't never seen so many dummies in one piece of business in all my life. From all walks of earth, it's some dummies. So you don't have to believe the deal. You don't have to. I ain't making you. I ain't telling you to believe it. I ain't telling you to not believe it. I'm telling you what I know. I'm telling you right now, I'm 100 and some thousand million percent scam. There's no deal. Mike is not going to call the deal dead because he does not want that 3 years, 7% to start. And I'm going to tell you something right now. All you want is your money back. You don't care about no 7% because that ain't nothing but a few dollars. 7%, like if you gave $250, 7% was going to get you another $250. No, he didn't say 100%. He said 7. That's only a couple of dollars. That's gas for your car. That's it. And maybe you can go to Canes or something. I don't know. That's it. At this point in time, just get your money back. You can tell me, man, you know what, I'm going to say this. You kiss my ass with that 7%. Excuse me, y'all, I had to say that, okay? Nobody want that 7%. It sounded good when we go, oh, you going to give us back, guarantee? Now, watch this now. There's another thing y'all keep missing. You cannot get a refund. And he was right. You cannot get a refund on this deal because I have not declared this deal dead as a doorknob. But you can get a refund and a chargeback if it's a scam. And seeing that it is,
go get your money. One thing he did not put in all that paperwork is, if this is a scam, because if we had seen the word, if this is a scam, you can't get your money back either. We wouldn't even went in there. Am I right? Where my real people at? I need my real people to speak up on this one. If we had a scene in that same paperwork where it says there ain't no refunds, if we had a scene in that same paperwork that says if this is also or turns out to be a scam, you also don't get your money back at all. We never would have went in. Never would have went in. Y'all keep letting people fool y'all, man. I told y'all I was going to go dark. I told y'all I was going to have something for you when I came back. And I'm still going to try. Because there's 100 something people in this room. There's tens and tens of thousands that are still missing. Okay? So, I'm gonna say this. I really hate that the group leaders are doing what they're doing. I really hate that they're doing what they're doing. It really, when you start to think back to those group leaders that are actually trying to tell you what not to do and still trying to get you to sign up for stuff with Mike G and all that, especially when you ain't already got some of your other money, it really makes you think about, like, were you told this in the beginning about this scam, or did you just now find this out? Yeah, and who not to talk to. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're supposed to be a group leader and you're supposed to be for the people yourself. If you just came right off the street and you took my money and you really turned it in over to Mike and you really did nothing wrong, at this point in time, you see the issue. So why are you not standing up for your people? Don't that make y'all think? I'm asking my real people here. Don't that make y'all think? Like, you can't be that dumb as a group leader to not stand up to Mike. When you're talking about that one person opposed to the tens of thousands that are in this deal and the thousands that's in your group that you were responsible for and who you took money from. You don't think that those group leaders should be standing up for y'all right now? Don't y'all think that they should be stepping? I'll tell y'all what, answer that question. Should they be standing up for y'all or against y'all right now? I'm going to ask that question. Should they be standing with you or against you? Which one is it? Y'all answer that question. Where about that? You see what I'm saying? They should be with you guys, man. Hell, they should have said, you know what, Sam? Forget all this stuff right here, man. I want to talk to the SEC and the FBI and DOJ you talking to. Because I'm finna tell everything else I know. And I'm going to tell them the truth of what I did. I'm going to get my slap on this wrist as to what I did. But I'm sure going to tell them what the mother did. And I'm going to give me some type of immunity for myself. That's what they should have did. Right? That's what they should do. Man, let me get some immunity for myself. I'm being thrown up under the bus. Mike telling y'all one thing, but he working for the state while y'all still up here trying to say, let's get Neil out of jail. Let's get Neil out of jail. Yay, let's get Neil out of jail. Y'all sound stupid. God. That's what I have for y'all, man. If y'all got some questions, y'all can ask them right quick. I call myself trying to always make sure that I cover my tracks in this thing since I started. I knew that somewhere along the way I was going to be accused of something. I always made sure I had myself backed up. My mother always told me that. I knew something somewhere was going to, something was going to happen. I didn't know when. I didn't know whether it was going to be good or bad. I didn't know. But I knew along the way
Documentation beats conversation. And I just showed y'all all the documentation. I really hate it for even in some form, because his whole dare to dream thing was just, he just really believed Mike. If he got something to do with it, then he should be right along there with him. Ignorance of the law is no excuse. Ignorance of the law is no excuse. You know what, Greg, man? As far as the Bitcoin, I don't know, man, but my people over there in the MGU, they do a, I'm gonna tell y'all something. Y'all can like them or not. I know me and MGU and them, we didn't had our day. You know what I'm saying? But I'm gonna tell you right now, if you guys really want to know, because I'm not on the crypto thing, they do a lot more research on that part. They might be able to help you a little bit more on that, because they're gonna tell you, well, shoot, it's either a done data, or you might have to take these avenues to, you know what I'm saying? So I don't know, Greg. I don't know. I know Dream and them and Nona and all them, Wayne and them is over here as well. So I don't know, man. I'm not the big crypto guy. You know, I do everything else, or at least try to. As I saw regarding the runs Linda made in October and November, when she said she sent the money to Mike and TWP members, firefighter. Yo, do your chargebacks. Do it on the PayPal. I mean, what is it? The Paymaster stuff. Do it. Do it. Do it. I hate this. Some innocent. Y'all do know that in the midst of all this, there are a few innocent. Now, I ain't going to say all of them. I'm going to tell you right now, 97% of the group leaders are straight out rotten wrong with what they're doing right now. 90% of them. 70% of the admins are wrong. Because I'm going to tell you something, some of them admins are caught in the middle. But at this point in time, some of them, you don't know who's who because they're not speaking up, which they should be. Who cares if you are an admin on PMC? If PMC is wrong, you need to tell everybody, even if they kick you out of PMC. So what if they kick you out? They don't have a heaven or hell to even put you in. Bye. You ain't got to kick me out. I'm leaving. If you're an FFG, TWP, and one of them. But some of them are so stupid that they just rather sit there and go down with the ship. So go on down with the ship then. Go on down with the ship. There you go. Go down with the ship. Probably got a handful of good, honest folk in the middle of something and don't know who did what for real, only by what was told to them. You even got some of them that had money put in their account because a group leader told them to. And now they caught up in this mess and possibly could get a slap on the wrist or lose the jobs that they have and stuff like that. I'm sensitive to it all, y'all. I thought about everything. Yeah, I know I come in here and I go hard. I go real hard. But that's what it is, man. It's about what's right. It's about what's right. I don't know what else to tell everybody, man. I was 100-some% that this thing was real and I had all the inside information. I dropped nuggets all through January, February, March, April, May. I was King Pro Deal. King Deal. But once you find out the truth about something, people, I don't care how much of it that you don't want to believe. Once you find out the truth, you have a moral obligation to tell it. You guys believed, I ain't saying just believed in me, but we believed in each other, right? We believed in each other. We followed each other. We talked, we cried, we laughed, we got angry, we did everything. So I knew I had the following. And you believed in what I said. And I apologize for maybe not even doing even a more deeper investigation last year, but I didn't start till December. Maybe I should have been in this thing longer than that. So I apologize that I wasn't around longer. I apologize that I got duped. Because nobody was bigger. Nobody was a bigger supporter than me, man. So I hate that I had to show that much support for something that was a scam. I'm just glad I didn't tell y'all to put money in it. Because I would have been just like them. And I am so glad that I wasn't trying to push people to drop money into this deal. Oh my God, I'm so glad about that. I just supported that it was real and it was going to close. Because I had inside information through either Mike Neal or whatever Gary said on the first conversation and all the other stuff that I had been doing. So I apologize, y'all. But once I found out the truth, I could not hold that. And I think, or better yet, I know that's probably what Mike was wanting me to be paid for. Not me asking for no dang on $7,500. Because I showed that email for y'all that missed it, right? Everybody else in here that saw the email, y'all saw that email, right? Did y'all see the email when I showed that he sent me an email about me being on his payroll and the recording? I didn't need to lie, y'all. That's why I always keep proof. I don't never want to come in here and lie to y'all about nothing. Nothing. Okay? So I knew wasn't nobody going to have my back personally like that except for my close friends. You guys would have tore me a new butthole if I didn't have none of that proof that he asked me to be on his payroll. Oh, man, y'all would have told me, oh, my goodness. What'd you say, Debra? Tell me for to shut you up. I don't know. Debra, you might want to retype that. I don't know what you're saying. Tell me for it to shut you up. You got to retype that. You said you put a word in, tell me to shut you up. Okay. Oh, well, I think I get what you say. Yeah, you tell me to shut up all the time, especially when I'm doing something wrong. Man, yeah, he wanted to pay me on a weekly basis. Whew. Dreaming them say you should have took that money. You should have took it. He owe you way more than that. All the stuff you done, he owe you way more than $7,500. And even if you did ask him for $7,500, he owe you way more than that. So, Mike, I want my money. Yeah, I want my money. Where my $7,500 at? Since you put a number on it, you put a number on it, I ain't said nothing. Drop me my $7,500. I needs it now. You know what I'm saying? Drop me my $7,500. Matter of fact, I need my 100. I'm going to tell y'all the truth. I'm going to tell y'all the truth. I'm going to tell y'all the truth. I was supposed to get paid. Don't y'all shake, rattle, and roll too much. What I'm going to tell y'all. Okay? I'm going to tell y'all I was supposed to get paid. I was supposed to been got paid $100 billion from this deal. I know some of y'all like, damn!
Yeah.
100 billion was my pay. If the deal, if this was a real deal to close, so y'all, you know, your boy would have been buying everything up in the world. Oh man.
Yeah, he probably is.
I don't care. Him and his minions. Somebody put a picture of a minion up. If y'all don't mind, somebody please put a group of minions or something up. If y'all don't mind, one of my people's in here. Deborah, what you trying to say? Anyway, I still get $100 billion. That was my pay. So what my $100 billion? Am I charging you, Gary, Neil? Which one of y'all? Who got it? Oh, yeah, sis. Yeah, I probably would have been part of that, too. You ain't lying. I'm glad I wasn't. Lord, there was a reason why I wasn't, though. There's a reason why. There go the minions. That's Mike G right there up front with the one eye. That's Gary behind him, and that's Neil in the bottom of the screen. No, that's Neil over there jumping to the right. My fault. All right, y'all. I had to laugh. Hey, guys. Man, I love y'all all the God love, man. Don't let nobody dupe y'all. Don't let nobody tell y'all what not to do. And don't let nobody tell you what to do either. I think you make your own mind up. Do your chargebacks. And do your thing. Do your thing. Okay? I need my billion, homeboy. $1 billion. And I don't want any no crypto. I want fungolas. I want my money. So you want to tell everybody I'm broke. Yeah, I'm broke, just like everybody else. Gas prices high, food high, cars high, electric high, water bill high, everything high. So yeah, we all broke. We want our money, homie. We want our money. Run that. Y'all be good. Okay? It is what it is.
Thinking of a master plan. This ain't nothing but sweat inside my hand. So I dig into my pocket, all my money spent. So I should default, and 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 so I should default.